Members of the NRM Parliamentary Caucus showed up at Parliament cladded in party colours and with their luggage ahead of Changkwanzi retreat that has started today. They were later flagged off by the government chief whip Dennis Hamson Obua to the National Leadership Institute in Changkwanzi district, where they are slated to spend 10 days.
So kindly, if you already have your tags, have the luggages packed such that we are set on motion. All right? God bless you all and safe journey.
Legislators could not hide their excitement and many shared their expectations, ranging from the government flagship program of the parish development model, which they want to discuss with the president at length, to iron out bottlenecks for its smooth implementation. Other issues highlighted include the manifesto implementation and road infrastructure breakdown across the country.
Issues that I am looking at while in Changkwanzi, number one is the implementation of the parish development model. So far how it has started being implemented on ground. And secondly, I am interested to know about the percentage of NRM manifesto implementation in major areas of education, health.
The NRM legislators have been joined by independent MPs led by the Dean of Independence in Parliament, David Livingstone Zijan, who explained why independents cannot afford to be left out of this retreat.
I've referred to us correctly that we are independents, implying that we are unaligned. We work with everyone. We work with all parties. We acknowledge that the NRM government is the party in power. And so we cannot work in isolation of where power lies.
Legislators noted that Changkwanzi meeting is a big opportunity they have to face the president and remind him of unfulfilled pledges in their constituencies.
To Changkwanzi for a 10-day retreat as NRM parliamentary caucus. But of course, when we are there, we always get an opportunity to address the president or to discuss with the president. But me, when I reach there, of course, I remind the president about the presidential pledges in Greater Luweero, particularly Nakasongola.
Definitely unfulfilled pledges are equally many. And the government, it is important, takes us through on the opportunities that are available in terms of fulfilling those very many pledges across the country.
Speaking on politics, legislators have hope that President Museveni will be able to speak out and guide them on the rivalry within NRM between the two factions of those supporting President Museveni to return in 2026 and the other wing promoting his son, Gen. Muhoozi Kainerugaba, to replace him in 2026.
It's MK, then there is the president. And the president has not come out clearly to explain the caucus members why this movement of MK, and I'm told he met that team and they discussed, and I think now that we have a retreat as a family, we should also resolve this.
You see, sometimes you're seeing my big brother MK is traversing the country, greeting people and giving them the actually positive hope, because This guy is like a messiah now.
However, the government chief whip, Dennis Hamson Obua, spoke out on the tentative program of the retreat and its agenda. He urged constituents to bear with their representatives in absentia for the next 10 days.
We expect to handle critical matters of the party with the party chairman and be able to come with a way forward that is beneficial to the people of Uganda, who gave the NRM the mandate to lead this country for the next 5 years.
This retreat is expected to be officially opened tomorrow by the NRM party chairperson, General Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.